Dowsing combined with prayer and blessing, or we should to make it to extend it a little. Dowsing combined with applied intent through prayer and blessing is the most powerful spiritual tool I've ever found to understand what's going on behind the scenes in life with these energies, to understand what's going on in life, and to take charge of my life. And I say that often, that it's the most powerful tool I've ever found, that simple little tool combined with what's in our minds and hearts. But that's assuming that deep relaxation and meditation is a given. That's where the insight comes. That's where the spirituality understandings come in those moments where you forget the world. You forget the body and you forget the world. Dowsing is what makes my work work. It's what makes it easier to look, to teach what I do, to experience what I do, and it makes it easy for you to learn what I do. But dowsing is not really at the heart of my work. What's at the heart of my work is helping you to understand your unlimited potential as a spiritual being, as a spiritual being of light. We've all heard that we are light and things are, everything is light, and God created the universe with light, and God is light, and we think, yeah, that's interesting, that's right, you know, and we hear it. But you're gonna leave away from this long weekend understanding that much better. We really are light. We are energy beings living in a universe of energy, or in an ocean of energy. And we're changing the energies that are around us and within us with every thought, every action, and every emotion. So we vibrate at various frequencies. Even though these are a different kind of energy, they still have frequency associated with them. So we vibrate at a different frequency with every thought. In fact, every thought is a real thing. When you have a thought or send somebody a thought, you're sending that person a real thing. The thing that thoughts are is subtle energy. But these subtle energies, science doesn't accept them because we can't pick them up with any electronic meter or gauge or a radio or anything like that. There are energies around us that affect us. They can weaken us. Many people think, as we mentioned earlier, they can make us sick. But I think for the most part, it's the other way around. We affect the energies as much or more than they affect us. We, again, are changing these energies every moment of every day with every thought, action, and emotion. With negative thinking and emotions, we are putting detrimental energies into our living environment. I know I'm repeating myself a little bit, but I want to get these points across. With positive, joy-filled thinking, we are putting beneficial energies into our living environment, into our beings. And with directed intent, through prayer and blessing, we can take charge of that process and put the energies we want into our living environments and into our beings. And that sort of summarizes what we're going to be doing all weekend. Learning to experience these various kinds of energies, understand them a little bit, and understand a little bit about their nature, and then making them be what we want them to be, rather than this haphazard way that we typically go through life with these energies totally unaware of them.